post-secondary education. Ladies and gentlemen, I know that we look forward to this evening's presentation, so please let us welcome the President, Vice Chancellor of UOIT, our friend, Dr. Tim McTiernan.
Thank you very much. It's a privilege to be here among elected officials at the provincial, municipal and regional level, among colleagues and among friends, and among people who believe in the future of Canada as a country that celebrates diversity, that embraces diversity, and that contributes a model of how to do it right to other countries and other regions. Next August, not this coming August, but the August after, 27th, at about 2:30 in the afternoon Pacific time, will mark the 40th anniversary of my arrival, my wife's arrival, my daughter's arrival in Canada. We came here thinking that it would be relatively easy. We came from Ireland, we spoke English, we thought we knew the education system, we thought we knew the culture, and we did, and we didn't. But we were able to build a life here, as many of us have been. We were accepted, we had opportunities, and we were able to learn to live with people from around the world. And the topic of tonight's discussion is very fitting as the art of living with others, the art of relationship. It reflects a style. It reflects an approach to interpersonal relations, intercultural relations, intergroup relations. It reflects a consideration of others and the ability to take others' points of view. And it struck me as I was sitting here during the wonderful meal and looking at the videos and listening to some of the earlier comments that we have a lot to be proud of in this country. I was at a workshop at lunchtime at Ryerson University in the business faculty that involved business leaders and it involved academics. And there was a worry about productivity in Canadian business and industry and a growing gap in productivity with the United States and how we might close that gap. And the tone of the discussion was one of concern, not an inappropriate concern, but one of concern about what we needed to do better at some of the business work we do, some of the successes we have. In a context like this tonight, we're reminded that we do better than anybody else as a country and as a nation in the way in which we embrace and celebrate diversity, absorb it into the national psyche and respect people's cultural backgrounds and cultural traditions in the process. We are a mosaic. We don't try and wipe away culture, and we have powerful strength in our government institutions, in our communities, and in our relationships, and in our style of life as a result of it. So the art of building relationships is a hard work, but one that is respectful and one that reflects a quality of community and a quality of nation that is second to none. Art, though, is being celebrated in another way tonight, and we see some wonderful essays and some wonderful pieces of art produced by creative, imaginative students. And art as a process and art as a product is a fundamental aspect and a core expression of our culture. And art is important, whether it's the weaving in its highest form, whether it's pottery and porcelain in its highest form, our buildings and institutions, Topkapi, the Blue Mosque, the Alhambra, St. Paul's Cathedral in London, expressions of the core values of a culture which allow people to understand who they are and what their identity is, and to reflect their aspirations and hopes for the future, and a sense of what the culture and what society might be. Art allows us to know ourselves, and in allowing us to know ourselves, it allows us to form meaningful relations with other people, understanding the expression of their art, understanding who they are, and building bridges across communities and across cultures. We saw in some of the clips Roman ruins in Turkey. They're Roman ruins, but they're Roman ruins in a particular context, in a particular culture. And the style subtly modified, subtly adapted by what the communities in the region had to offer. In the same way that what the communities in the region had to offer drifted back into Rome as the trade links and as the governance links, good and bad, went backwards and forwards. So art is a bridge, and a significant bridge, that can inform the style of us living and working together. And in all of this, it's extraordinarily fitting that IDI, in sponsoring this evening, focused on art as a form of expression and as a style. Because IDI, as we've seen and as we know, promotes cultural understanding, it promotes fellowship. It is, as an organization, a powerful reflection of our diversity nationally, regionally, and in the Durham region in particular. Our MC stole my line about the diversity at UOIT. We capture what Durham region has to offer in spades. We capture a range of cultures and a range of backgrounds, and people working together in groups, learning from each other, contributing to a really rich student environment, and connected out into the world through our professors, through our graduate students, through placements and through projects. And part and parcel of what we are as an institution with our partner Durham College and our partner Trent University is to reflect the best of our region and to build connections outside of our region so that we and our children can move backwards and forwards. I'll speak briefly and then finish because I'm the only person between you and the most important part of the evening. Art is an incredible part of innovation. To get back to my comment about the discussion at lunchtime about innovation and productivity in the workplace and in the manufacturing process. Art is the reason new materials are created. Art and media go together. Art provides new ways of thinking about relationships and new ways of thinking about the world. And art and science in that regard are inseparable. They're both parts of the creative process, and it's creativity that provides us with the mindset that fosters a common community across our diversity. So thank you.